Okay, our last problem, we're measuring the height of the chronovore egg quip. Chronovore literally from time eater. So we're taking two sidings, one 50 feet directly behind the other, and we're measuring the elevation to the top of egg quip. So we'll draw egg quip here as some terrible monster. And we'll assume that we're on level ground. And we take two sidings to the top of A-quip. So we take one siding. This is 53 degrees. And then we take another siding. And the angle of elevation there is 48 degrees. And we're told that these sidings are taken 50 feet apart. And we're trying to figure out the height. We'll call H of A-quip. So what we have here, if I abstract this a little bit, we have a problem with two right triangles. This is 50, this is 53 degrees, and this is 48 degrees. And that's what I'm calling H. And the object is to figure out what H is. Now, in order to use the trigonometric functions we know of, for example, in this triangle here, all I have is 53 degrees. And this side, I'm trying to find this side H. I need at least one other side. So we're just going to call this one X. So the tangent of 53 degrees is H over X. And now that I have labeled this side, I can look at the tangent of 48 degrees as h over x plus 50. All right, so to see that, let's just draw each triangle. And so here the tangent of 53 degrees is the opposite over the adjacent, h over x. And here the tangent of 48 degrees is h over x plus 50. So what I'm really getting here, folks, is a system of equations. It's a system of nonlinear equations. Tangent of 53 degrees, whatever that is h over x. And tangent of 48 degrees, whatever that is h over x plus 50. So what am I after? I'm after the height h. So if I'm after the height h, what I need to do is pick one of these equations to solve for x and then substitute that into the other equation. So which of these equations is easier to solve for x? Arguably the first one. So that's going to be our strategy. Solve this for x and substitute it into the second equation. Okay, so from this equation, I can multiply both sides by x and get x tangent 53 degrees is h. So solving this for x, I get x equals h divided by the tangent of 53 degrees. Now, in order to avoid carrying this fraction around, the reciprocal of tangent of 53 degrees is going to be cotangent of 53 degrees. So I'll use that. So what I do is in this equation, everywhere I see an x, I replace it with h cotangent 53 degrees. So now the second equation, becomes h over h cotangent 53 degrees plus 50. All right, so clearing the denominators, I multiply both sides. Like so. And when I look at this equation, the highest power of h I see is h to the first power. So that means what I want to do is get all the h's on one side, factor out the coefficient, and divide through. So the first step to do that, I could divide through by tangent of 48 degrees. I could multiply this through. At the end of the day, it's not going to make any difference. I'll go ahead and multiply this through. I get h times the cotangent of 53 degrees times the tangent of 48 degrees plus 50 times the tangent of 48 degrees is equal to h. So getting all the h's on one side, I have that h minus this thing is equal to 50 tangent of 48. Factoring out the h, I get 1 minus cotangent 53 degrees tangent 48 degrees. Divide through, I get h equals 50 tangent 48 degrees divided by 1 minus cotangent 53 degrees tangent 48 degrees. Okay, so that's the exact answer, and then I would do is plug this in the calculator to get an approximation. So this is roughly 340, which means AQIP is roughly 340 feet tall. So that'll do it for number 6.